All right, the big day is here. It is closing day. Let's go over what you can expect when you are closing on your new house. So the title company should have at this point sent you all the final documentation that you're gonna need. So you're gonna know exactly how much money you need to bring to closing. And typically they're going to send you some wiring instructions. So you should go to your bank the day before the closing and wire whatever money that you need to wire to bring to closing, wire it to the title company ideally the day before closing. There's gonna be a lot of chaos going on your closing day. Don't have one more thing where you gotta go to the bank and have something else to worry about. Do that the day before closing if that's possible. The next thing you gotta know is you gotta have the power on in the property on your name. So you're gonna have to call FPL. Realistically, it's easier to do it online. It takes only about 5 minutes, but you have to have the power on in your name for the day of closing. So make sure that's on. The worst thing that could happen is you get there to go to the walkthrough and there's no power in the house, you can't see anything. That's not what we want. So you as the buyer are responsible for the day of closing. Make sure you turn the power on in your name. Water, you're not gonna be able to turn on until after closing. At closing, they're gonna give you obviously a closing statement showing that you're the true and rightful new owner of the property. You're gonna be able to go to the city or municipality, wherever the water is controlled for the property that you're buying. You'll have to show them that you're the true owner and turn the water on in your name, but that can't be done until after closing. So remember, power on before, water on after. So on the day of closing, we're gonna do a final walkthrough of the property 1 hour before you close on the property. So if you have a closing time set with the title company for 10 a.m., we're gonna meet at the property at 9 a.m. and do a final walkthrough. So the goal of this final walkthrough is to make sure that the home is in the perfect condition, the exact condition that you expect it to be in prior to you going in and signing on the dotted line, because there are no refunds at this point. So the point of the walkthrough, we're there to make sure that the home is in the same condition it was in when you wrote the offer and when you did your inspection. So we're really seeing, did the seller leave the house? Did they leave anything in the house that they weren't supposed to leave? Did they damage anything on the way out the door? You know, did the movers bump into some walls or anything like that? Are all the appliances still there and working? Stuff like that. We're gonna turn on the sinks, flush the toilets, turn on the showers. Just make sure the home is in the perfect condition. There's no crazy, unexpected things that broke sometime between when you did your inspection and the closing date, so you know exactly what it is that you're buying. Because like I said, there are no refunds with this. Make sure you got no problems. A good tip is for the day of closing, take the day off, or at the very least, take a half a day off. When you go to the closing, it's gonna take about an hour, maybe a little over an hour, depending on how many questions that you ask. That's if you're getting a mortgage. If you're paying cash and you don't have a mortgage, it's maybe 20, 30 minutes tops. But most people are getting mortgages. It's gonna take you at least an hour, so make sure you don't work that day. Now, you can't get the keys to your new property until the file officially funds. So just because you're done signing doesn't necessarily mean that the title company is allowed to hand over the keys to you. The file has to officially fund and the wire has to be sent. So this is a behind the scenes process that we really, you know, don't have any access to. So it kind of comes down to the lender that you choose. This is why working with a reputable lender is really important. A bad lender, especially if they're over in California and, you know, you're closing 9 a.m. Eastern time, they're not gonna have the wire and the money sent out on a lot of cases until later in the day. So it's gonna hold you up, but you can't get the keys until everything funds. A good lender should have no problem with it, but it depends on the lender. So another tip for you is don't schedule your movers for the day of closing. Just out of an abundance of caution, movers are typically gonna charge you by the hour. So if you have movers sitting there with all your stuff on a truck, waiting for the file to fund and waiting for you to get keys, you could end up paying a lot of money. Just out of an abundance of caution, have the movers come the following day. You should be able to get the keys the day of closing. There should be no reason why you wouldn't. And you could start moving little stuff into the house then, but just to make sure you don't rack up a very, very expensive moving bill, schedule the movers for the day after you close. So that's it for closing. Congratulations, you are officially a homeowner. This is super, super exciting. Don't forget, our relationship isn't over yet. We're gonna stay in touch. I'm gonna check in with you, make sure everything's going well. I wanna make sure that if you have any friends and family that I'm able to help them as well, because I know at this point you are super, super happy with our service. Thank you for tuning into this video series on how to buy a house in South Florida. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Give me a call, shoot me a text, send me an email. I promise I don't bite. Even if you're not looking to buy for 6 months or 6 years, I'm here to answer your questions. Thank you for tuning in.